Before Adam, there was this world. And before this world, there was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't have a beginning. Now that Allah Azza wa Jal has an ending. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, where was Allah Azza wa Jal before this world? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that Allah Azza wa Jal, he had his throne, and his throne was above the water.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala amma ba'd.
My young friends, this dunya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so big that there is space in this dunya for billions and billions and billions of more people. But what is this dunya in comparison to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created out there? It means nothing. It is worthless. So worthless, compare it with the sun. The sun is one star. Take this planet Earth and you place it inside the sun and you will be able to place 1.3 million Earths in the sun. 1.3 million Earths in the sun. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. There are stars out there which are millions of times bigger than the sun, that you need millions and millions of stars to make one galaxy, that there are zillions of galaxies out there.
Now, everything that we've spoken about in regards to the universe, in regards to the galaxies, in regards to the trillions of stars and the trillions of planets and so on and so forth, all of that comes under as-sama ad-dunya, the first heaven.
And Allah is the creator of seven heavens. Seven heavens! And the distance between the first heaven and the second heaven is 500 years. At what speed? Only Allah knows. Only Allah knows. But it will take 500 years to get from the first heaven to the second heaven. 500 years from the second to the third. Third to the fourth. Fourth to the fifth. Fifth to the sixth. Sixth to the seventh. Every time it will take 500 years. After the seven heavens, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. You all read the Ayatul Kursi. You all know the Ayatul Kursi. After this, you have the Kursi of Allah. You have the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Al-Kursi is the footstool, which Sa'id ibn Jubayr radiallahu ta'ala anhu said is like a stair to the arsh, is like a stair to the throne. All of these heavens compared to the Kursi is like a ring in the desert.
The seven heavens is the ring, and the Kursi of Allah is the Sahara Desert. After the Kursi of Allah, my young friends, you have the arsh of Allah.
And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the Kursi compared to the throne, compared to the arsh, is like a ring in the desert. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above His throne.
This time, the ring is the Kursi and the arsh is the desert. What is the Kursi in comparison to the arsh of Allah? Nothing. Then you have angels which carry the arsh of Allah. Their heads are in the seventh heaven and their feet are in the lowest earth. My friends,
then you have
the Lord of the arsh and kursi. لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير. He is beyond the size of Allah. Who Allah is. The greatness of Allah is beyond the comprehension of my little mind.
And Allah is above His throne, but nothing is hidden from Him. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions Himself many times in the Quran as the Lord of the glorious throne, Rabbul Arsh al-Majid or Rabbul Arsh al-Azim, that Allah Azza wa Jal knows everything that goes in and out of the earth, everything that falls from the skies, and everything that's produced from the skies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the slightest details of this world. So do not think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is distant. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did he tell us? He said that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed his creation, he wrote with himself upon the throne, Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi, that verily my mercy overtakes and supersedes my anger. That is what is prescribed on the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His mercy is greater than His anger.